We moved over to the boxing department. As we moved to the boxing department, we call it boxing going back to the 1970s. And these boxes were actually put in like boxes we pulled separate and fiberglassed into the hull of the boat. Right now, we glass these to the deck of the boat, and then we come back and fiberglass them to the subfloor assembly. So the actual floor assembly will be fiberglassed to this part, reinforcing that hull. This is a step assembly, has a foam box under it. Then this goes directly to the floor. This is a Puma FTD. The Puma FTD, Cougar FTD, and some of the other boats have full box assemblies and finished boxes. Some of the other ones, like the Pantera 2 and the Sabre, they don't. They actually are inside finished box, but it's not gel coat slick. It's smooth and brushed. The partitions on this are all done in fiberglass. This is a pretty slick part right here on the front. This pulls all the flex out of the front trolling motor area. It's a really neat thing because it takes that flex out of the deck where that trolling motor works. Then again, we come to the back side of that trolling motor and use those 3/8 plates under it to support the trolling motor bracket. But this is boxing. This is where the deck assembly on a Puma FTD is. We've got a hull assembly we're going to look at, and we'll move right on through it. Well, let's spend just a minute. This is a Cougar Advantage Elite hull. The Cougar Advantage Elite, basically all the 20-foot hulls are very similar. The striping's different, but the integrity of the hulls is the same. The stringers, the subfloor, they're the same on all the 20-foot models. There's different molds for them, but they're the same parts, basically. This one's got the front foam chamber. All the rear foam chambers are in place, and then the floor is foamed. And you can see there's 8 separate areas that we integrate foam into in these areas. That encapsulate all the foam, so all the foam is contained inside of these foam chambers. Down the road 10 years from now, none of that's going to be in the gunnels of your hull absorbing water. It's all going to be contained. As long as you keep the integrity of these boxes in place, you don't drill them, you don't not seal something, they'll be dry, and that foam will maintain throughout the whole life of this boat. Another thing you can notice right here is the width of the transom. The transom's full width. It runs from this point to that point all the way across and depth-wise. So that full transom, that 65-pound transom that we looked at out there, it stretches through this whole bottom and all the way across in full depth. It's a nice setup. This is a one-piece construction hull right here, all vacuumed together with our vacuum process. This boat, this Puma FTD, it just came out of boxing. We're standing in the finish department where the next step, it moves into wiring, hanging all the parts and the pumps. The nice thing about that, as you, out in your home, if you want to work on a pump on the lake and it's a problem, you can get to it, you can access it. You can get to every part in this boat, no different than we're going to do at the next step of this when we install it. Everything is put in at this stage of the game. So when your boat's done at this stage, it's going to be finished with the parts that you can access in the field. It's going to cut your cost of rigging. So when you go in to have a pump installed later, your service in the field is going to be less because the dealer's not going to have to charge you to remove a gas tank. He's not going to have to charge you to remove a seat box to install a bilge pump. There's so many things that people don't think about in service. And service is a big factor when you come to building a boat. This boat is in its first day that you could actually put this boat on the water. We could take this boat, we could move it right to the lake tomorrow with a console, a seat, and a motor, and run this boat. It is a one-piece construction unit. All of the boxes are fiberglassed together. Everything is sealed and seamed. We have one area in this boat we use to indicate use. Outside of that, everything is one piece. It should never give you any trouble. It's all done with double laminate glass. All the component boxes are glassed to the hull. The deck and hull assembly is not made to ever come apart.